Awesome, thank you. We are doing the spleen series today, the stomach and spleen. Does anybody know, everybody know what the spleen is? Meltz? Mielte? Good question. Well, we're going to get really into that. And I'm going to answer you more from the anthroposophical and Chinese medicine way than... And Uncle Google can sort in the rest of it for you. That was good, though. We're going to start in butterfly. So bring your feet in front of you, two hands length in front of your groin. And a good check is to see if you can sit upright. And if you can't, you can use your sweater or coat as a block. You guys got it, though. And then lift up tall and bring your chin to your chest and start to curl down. And let your head just drop towards your feet. And you can kind of wiggle around and make the pose fit your body for the first couple of moments in the yin pose. And then once you've found the right shape for your body, on purpose, soften and relax into the shape. And take a couple moments to actually commit to stay in the shape and the pose. And it won't be more than usually, like, in a whole yin class, we don't ever hold poses for longer than 10 minutes. The norm is about 5 minutes-ish. Take a full breath in, and with your exhale, just sigh out. Take some time to check in with your physical body. And make sure you just don't focus on the parts that are painful or hard or where you're struggling. Also focus on the parts that you feel good about or feel strong. And then take a couple breaths to notice your energy, the life that is flowing through you. And again, check in both ends of the spectrum. Not only noticing where your chi is blocked or there's too much prana, but also notice the places where it feels smooth and you feel alive and expressive. Take a couple of moments to notice your feelings this morning. And practice getting out of the story in your head and just noticing how the feelings express themselves in your body. with your next inhale, roll up. Perfect when we're in the feeling question to do a lion's pose. So bring your hands behind you. Place your feet on the ground. You're going to stick out your tongue all the way down your chin. You're going to look at your third eye, and then you're going to roar, but as if you'd lost your voice, so with a whisper. Lift up your hips, squeeze your butt, stick out your tongue, look at your third eye, and go. Push the ground away one more time. One more time still. Lift up your hips and. And bring your hips back down if you don't have a nice little flavor saver. Wipe off your chin. And we're going to go into deer pose. So let your right heel be in front of you, your left heel behind you. If you can get there from here. Yeah. To make it more gentle, you bring your heels closer to your midline. To make it more challenging, you bring your feet further away from your spine. You can feel maybe that on the right side there's an outward rotation of your thigh, on the left side an inner rotation. So it affects your knees differently. So just be gentle. Lift up tall. Your foot.
Like this?
Whatever's comfortable, actually. So it's really mostly like to satisfy your knee. So my foot just naturally kind of... Oh, is that my foot?
Yes.
No, I'm just kidding. But it just naturally kind of points out, and that's the most comfortable. You've got one of those too. Extra feet just flying around. Awesome. And now lift up tall and turn to your right, putting your left hand to the outside of your right knee. You can take your right arm behind you to help you stay lifted here a little bit. But for this variation, drop your head. Beautiful. And take some time to just check in with your thinking this morning. And you might not have been awake for so long, or you might be doing this at the end of your day. So just notice. What's the character of your thinking today? And again, it's not so much of interest, like you're not observing what you're thinking about, but the manner in how you're thinking about it. So, you know, sometimes we get kind of stuck in a loop, thinking the same thought over and over again. Other days we have more alacrity in our thinking, more inspiration and new thoughts. And then to check in with our spirit body, this kind of elusive, hard to reach, eternal part of ourselves. Today we're going to honor the spleen and the stomach theme. So really just see what, either remember an intention, like an intention you like to set over and over again, or create a new one. The spleen is said in traditional Chinese medicine to house thought. And it's the house of our intentions. And the biggest kind of theme of the spleen and stomach is that they govern transformation and transportation. And then unwind, do a little bow to your left hand side. And you're gonna place your, unwind and place your right foot on the ground and stretch your left leg back behind you. If you're like over 20, you might have to fold the ends of your mat in to put some extra padding underneath your back knee. And the first variation of dragon that we're going to do is we're going to actually slide our heel a little closer to us, and it's called overstepping dragon. So you actually let your knee come in front of your ankle, which is something we don't do very often. And we're not holding this for 10 minutes, where it's a much more yang, yin pose. Mm-hmm. So because you actually want to squeeze into that stretch of your Achilles and the back of your heel. And then wiggle your foot forward so that your ankle is slightly in front of your knee. And then turn your foot out to 45 degrees. And this is baby dragon wing. Don't they sound like good dishes? Okay, and you're going to roll out to the outside of your pinky toe. Let the bottom of your foot lift up. And it's like you're dropping a wing here. And you can either stay here, or you might be able to just like comfortably come down to your elbows. Or you can maybe just lie down on the ground. Or stay here. Exactly. You don't want to get too fancy in twisting and making a different move. It's like that Swedish word lagom. Make it perfect. No, make it exactly the right place for you. You can feel in these poses that kind of holds you responsible to it. Notice if your back foot is sickled, maybe stretch your big toe long. That's good pair. And then grateful that we're not holding this for 10 minutes. Lift up, and you're going to toe heel your right foot over to your left, and you're going to come into swan. So we usually do sleeping swan, where we bow forward right away. And today we're going to stay lifted here for a little bit. Again, you might find, so you wanna have your hips squared. So I can sit down, but you're not ready to sit down there yet. You can use your sweater or a block underneath your right buttocks and help you kind of bring the earth up to you. And for some people it helps, and some people just doesn't think it makes a difference. I have another fluffy jacket if you need another. No different. And again, we're not holding this for 10 minutes, so you can kind of hold yourself up with your hands and feel the squeeze into your left kidney. Ah. Notice if you can breathe and, like, you know, important things like you remember your name. So the stomach and kidney series is connected to the element of earth. And both the stomach and spleen together are the organs that are most responsible for taking the food that we take in from the outside world and turning it into us. We really see the physical elements of the stomach breaking down, breaking down the food. But then it's the spleen that is responsible of like taking the nutrients out of the food. Now start to walk your arms forward, coming into sleeping swan, laying your chest down on the ground, stretching your arms out. Ish, if that works for you, or if it doesn't. So I was on this kick for a long time saying like, ooh, obedience is for dogs. And that's still true. But really, we want to start to learn to let our obedience be to really something lofty and big. You know, to idealism, to your intentions, to who you want to become, to the divinity, to the forces of creation. But not necessarily to little men with clipboards. Okay, they don't even have to have a clipboard. But we want to break our unconscious habit of obedience. In all of the organ pairs in the Taoist picture of how our body really functions, there is a dynamic element of a relationship to the earth, material. Physical. But also a very clear connection to not only the psycho-emotional elements of our being, but our idealism and our aspirations. And in that vein, I want to read a text that's a quotation from a Serapis meditation given by Dr. Alfred Lingen, who is a Gnostic priest who started the Aquarian Spiritual Center. Because this division is still so much of what shapes our kind of destiny. Not only by ourselves, but on a bigger collective as well. I am black as the night from which the light of a new day descends. I am past, present, and future. I am the anointed of heaven. I am what I am. I am the blended colors of life that light the bridge into the new age. I am seed, plant, and flower. I am the anointed of earth. I am that I am. So on one hand, this anointed of heaven is kind of the last line of that stanza is I am what I am. That kind of implies this eternal element, this all-encompassing beingness past, present, and future as one. And then balancing this out is, I am the anointed of earth. I am that I am. And that subtle difference, it's actually a difference of one letter, the W versus the T, what or that, shows a different kind of thing where our choices, our action, our beingness in becoming is what defines the earth state. This poem is also very much connected from moving from the age of Pisces to moving into the age of Aquarius. And that in a new age, new capacities and new faculties are born to the human being. Inhale up. Push up into downward facing dog and just wiggle out and throw your right leg around. See that you can still move it. Ah, you can make noises. That's right, on a centuck. Moaning and groaning, socially okay. Let your fingers even spread out. And then, yes, take your left leg, stretch your left leg long, and then step your left foot forward. And we're going to start with dragon. I am totally kidding. We're going to start with deer because else we'd be lopsided. So my deer is put your leg down and bring your left heel in front of you and your right heel behind you. It is more deer like the animal, just in case you were confused. Making it more gentle by bringing your feet closer towards your center line, making it more intense. And then see, you can also sit on a lifted on a block or something if you need to. And then turn regally to your left. You can allow your left hand to help you stay lifted here and just bow your head down. So it's so crazy. We live in this age of materialism, but we as humanity don't take material that seriously. Yeah, this is part of why we have this problem with plastic in our oceans and our water, with like disregarding the impact that cutting into the earth has, ignoring how traumatic it is to mine or to cut down all the trees. Like, there's no actual reverence or real understanding of the value of material. And so we see this happening not only in these, you know, big companies making these choices, but down to the very, like, the individual level, where people don't take seriously what it is that they consume or collect. And that becomes true even for what we put in our mouth and eat. Now, don't get me wrong. You can eat cat food, as my dear friend Carolyn Miss says, and be, you know, intuitive and kind and good. Our morality is not dependent on what we eat, per se. Because that would be disregarding the biggest role the human being has, which is as a being that can transform matter. But with any free and dynamic system, whether we look at the cosmos, the earth, a community, or our own individuality and body, we can do things to support and build up the system and make the specialness easier, or we can abuse the system and rely on its transformation qualities to bring this resilience to the system. Now it's time for dragon. So unwind, do a little bow to your right hand side. And then, dun 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 dun, take your right leg back. Overstepping dragon. So let your knee actually reach in front of your ankle. Let your heel be dropping, feeling the stretch in your Achilles. And then slide your left foot a little bit forward. Toe heel your foot a little bit out, so that's about 45 degrees. Roll to the outside edge of your left foot on your pinky side and let your dragon wing open up. And then come down onto your elbows maybe, or lie down on the ground. And then lift up enough to toe heel your left foot to the right. And come first into lifted swan. Make sure that your left knee is just slightly to the left of your left hip. And then you can look behind you, and you want to make sure that your foot isn't like hooked. You want to stretch it out. And then see if you can either have your fists on the ground or your hands flat. Nice. Maybe feel that this posture kind of squeezes into our right kidney. So it's amazing with all these like incredible sophistication in our scientific tools, instruments, tools of measurement. There's not one simple answer or clear answer to what's the moment that the food becomes you. I mean, in a way, like, when does digestion, is it totally complete and done? And it's like a little vague. And in a way, this vagueness really should point us to insight rather than our lack of intellectual prowess. And part of the challenge, I think, is that you know, we're taking in part of the earth to bodies that are made of earth, so to say, or things that are of this world. And then it helps fuel not only our physical, like, locomotion and our physical energy in our body, but it also supports then our ability to think freely. So one of the ways that we can support kind of our freedom is by not overtaxing our body with substances that our body struggles with, which happen, weirdly enough, to be the exact same substances the earth struggles with. The earth can tolerate different poisons, of course, in a different way than us because it's much larger than us. Yeah, but if you think about like preservatives, for instance, are designed to keep food fresh on the shelf. And so it's actually counter to the forces of nature of decay and ripening, actually. And also in our body, the same thing. It's counter to what our digestion is trying to do, which is essentially kill, break down, and rot the food. Sounds really yummy, doesn't it? All right, walk your arms forward and come into sleeping swan. Either stretching your arms out, resting your forehead on the mat, or using your hands to give yourself a little pillow. So when our spleen is overburdened or sluggish is usually the reference to the spleen, or that the spleen is too damp, cold and wet. What happens is it's like the spleen then can't work as well. I mean, just think about like your hands being too cold and trying to fix a watch, yeah? You can't do those fine movements when your hands are so cold. And a little bit the same with the organ. So if the spleen is like damp and cold and can't quite work as well, you can kind of picture this on a very rudimentary level. Like picture that your food comes into your body and your spleen is really struggling. So it struggles to take the nutrients out of the food that you're providing, especially if you're providing food that has nutrients. And then your stomach digests the matter and you excrete the matter, and the nutrients are supposed to stay in your body to sustain and feed all of your different cells. So when the spleen is sluggish, the sensation, the experience we have is that we're still hungry after we've eaten if the spleen can't take the nutrients out of the food. And so then that drive of hunger will lead us to eat more, and maybe more than our body actually can handle or needs. And then that in turn overtaxes the spleen. Or maybe another picture helps kind of see the connection between this. Beer, for instance, is and wine a little bit less, but like a hair less, they both kind of dampen the spleen and tax the spleen, so it's not very effective. But the sensation then is one of hunger and the need for more. So maybe we can just imagine what's that like if we have this like overeating or over drinking kind of drive. How does that affect not only the physical functions of the stomach and the spleen, But then these psycho-emotional functions. The spleen houses thought and intention. So when the spleen is doing well, we have a connection to be able to trust each other, trust the ground, trust our path, to be honest, to be open and accepting, and to really be balanced, kind of impartial. But when it's challenged and taxed and struggling, the spleen and stomach expresses their imbalance in our psycho-emotional realm as too much worry and actually excessive thinking. So excessive means too much thinking. And one of the words often connected to our spleen being out of balance is becoming too dogmatic. Which translates to adhering to a text or scriptures by the word instead of by a digested and wise understanding of the material. So worry and excessive thinking, it points to the same thing, right? Where if we don't if we disregard the nature of thought or imagination or even of fear, then we take so seriously our worries and what we think. So we can think of it nearly, if we're not thinking good thoughts, well then we want more thoughts. Or think the same thoughts over and over again. And then inhale, lift up. Oh yeah. Wiggle it out, work it out in downward facing dog. Make some faces, make some moans and groans. Maybe throw in a bark if you need to. Wiggle around. And then come down onto your knees and tuck your toes under for toes pose. And again, you know, we're not practicing being like uber masochists. So just the right amount of pain. So this is one of the areas like really different relationship to this pose. Like I can probably sit here probably for about 20 minutes. I mean, I'll feel it afterwards, but like, and for other people that are like, you're insane, I can't even do that ever. Or I'm gonna have to, you know, either cut off my feet or hurt someone. So you kind of do just enough. Trust and honesty. Such an interesting kind of connection to our stomach and our spleen. Do you trust the food you're eating? Like I've been so privileged to grow up with like very whole grain foods and whole grains, fresh vegetables, really close to the earth foods, I guess I could say. And so sometimes I'll go into a supermarket, especially in the US, but also here in Sweden, and I'll walk up and down the aisles and be like, there's nothing for me to eat. Because it looks like half the stuff is like plastic or these weird colors or and I have no trust for it. And then, like, you know, you read the labels and you can't even understand what's in them. Like, there's no honesty, really, or transparency. Notice how you care less and less the more intense it gets for your toes. So your feelings change your experience. No, just kidding. All right, bring your hands forward and slap out your feet. Oh, it's okay. You think you don't want to, but it'll feel better. And then rock back onto your toes, stretching your ankles, really. So it's nice, the spleen series really goes into the feet a lot. You know, it's foundational. And then we're going to rock into, well, it's hard to make this one slick. Come onto your side. And this posture is called pulling the cat's tail. So you're going to stretch your top leg straight out from your hip. Your hand can be conveniently pillowing, yeah, your head. And then you're going to reach back and see if you can grab your other foot and pull your heel towards your buttocks. And you can really feel the stretch in, like, the belly of your bottom thigh. Now, this might be enough for you. Or if you want to add a little bit more of a twist, you can drop your shoulders down. You might find that actually moving your heels slightly away from your buttocks will be more of an intense stretch in the belly of your thigh. But you decide. Uh-huh. Yeah, you want to bring your leg up a little higher if you can. You stretch your leg out. No, out this way. Mm-hmm. And you might be able to move. Yeah, now you feel it more, yeah? That's where you're aiming for. Mm-hmm. It's actually incredible, and it's a testament to spirit that so many humans in this world survive on so little food and on such in such like poor quality, like not real food in my opinion. Like, that's amazing. Rudolf Steiner actually talks about how the fact that we can live without a spleen is testament to that there are higher forces supporting us than just our physical elements. Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. There we go. I mean, think about how much work that is then. For these other parts of ourselves. So maybe the story is, as we evolve as human beings, as humanity, that we increase our freedom by becoming actually more reverent, more respectful of materialism, more respectful of stuff, so that we can aim for this. And so that other forces that have been sustaining them, sustaining their ability to think, sustaining their physical bodies, can be freed up to do other development. You know, you see it quite clearly in children. We'll see how much was missing. But the receiver lost battery for a little bit. Black as the night from which the light of a new day descends. I am past, present, and future. I am the anointed of heaven. I am what I am. I am the blended colors of life that light the bridge into the new age. I am seed, plant, and flower. I am the anointed of earth. I am that I am. So know your own darkness. You know, when we turn inward, that world is for all of us. A world of darkness as well. And we become the source of light like the sun. So it's through our own kind of heavenly qualities or birthright of our ability to experience our own inner life, that we need that darkness, those boundaries of our personal kind of relationship to the divine, nearly, from which the light of a new day descends. And then when we turn to the outside realm of earth, I am the blended colors of life that light the bridge into the new age. Can we feel our connection to all people? To find brotherhood or fraternity. On the earth with all the various colorful expressions of what it is to be human. And roll back on your belly, moan and groan, push your hips back to your heels, cross your ankles, roll over your crossed ankles, and stretch your legs out, and you're like, I've totally lost it. So turn over and turn around. Flip and spin. And we're just going to do just a short little twist. You can do it with one leg or two. Starting with your right knee, take your both one knee or both knees to the left. Turn in the opposite direction. Take a full inhale, and with your exhale, just sigh it out. And just for a moment, imagine and think about how your intentions then feed you on a totally different level. Sustain you and lead you. And then bring your knees back to center, switch your legs. Pull your left knee in, or both knees, and drop your knee or knees to the right. Take your gaze in the opposite direction. And then unwind and stretch your legs out and find your way into Shavasana. Feel free to cover your eyes with something. Cover your body with a scarf or a jacket or anything. Turn your palms open to receive or relax your hands on your belly. Let the earth allow you to rest. And notice that you can still be aware and conscious even while you're still. Your next inhale, bring your breath to the edges of your body. Maybe wiggle your fingers and your toes, your face and your nose. And then you can stretch your arms long over your head, stretch your hands away from your feet away from your hands, and then gently roll onto your left-hand side, stimulating a yang channel along your spine. Take a couple moments and notice your own vibrancy and vitality. There's a reason you're here. And help yourself up into a comfortable seated position. Allow your hands to meet at heart center. Feel the ground below you, lift up tall above. And let's close with one om. Empty your breath. Take a deep inhale. Bring your prayer hands to your third eye. Invite the divine light. And as we bow forward together, we say, Namaste. Woo-hoo-hoo. Make a little noise to make sure, A, that you're awake and can get into things like a car and drive safely, but also just to clear the space of all the things we left behind.